Water's an absolutely scarce resource everywhere in the world and becoming scarcer. So knowing exactly how much water to apply and when to apply it is critical.
For us, it's an interesting science question. It's like you can see a crop growing, but you don't necessarily know how much water it's using.
The relationship between the Environment Agency and G2G team is very strong and solid. And this has allowed us to tap into a lot of research institutions within New Zealand.
For many years, we've been developing tools and gadgets to look at how water moves in the soil and how water moves in the plants. We typically, in the past, in New Zealand, have been working on apple trees and, you know, grapevines, and they have a certain size and a certain anatomy.
النخلة مختلفة جدا عن الشجرة، فبالتالي إنها تسحب المية من الوسط.
The computer model says if the flow looks like this in the stem, then we need to place our sensors at this depth, and we need to put this much heat into the measurement and the likes.
فنحن التجربة هذه اللي سويناها كتجربة عادية إن الري العادي اللي تم في المزارعين اللي استخدموها تقريبا كان في اليوم 275 لتر في اليوم.
Then quite quickly you can see if the grower is putting on 1,000 liters a day, then that's too much water. And so if we manage the irrigation efficiently, we should minimise the over-extraction of water by the farmers.
It's achieving a minimisation of water use, achieving an economic outcome and environmental sustainability.
We are measuring changes in soil moisture with technology that isn't supposed to work in salty soils, and our challenge is we have to deliver an answer.
Really, it's about innovation. We're taking our proven solutions and working with the Environment Agency Abu Dhabi to create sustainable change.
And the beauty of this relation, it was really smooth, it was really effective. I haven't seen anything like it.